Hello everybody, I'm Tari, welcome to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to make a Zulu necklace with some diamonds detail. So I've already made my beaded ball. If you do not know how to make this type of beaded ball, kindly refer to my previous video. I made a video on how to make this beaded ball. And then after that, I picked my 15 beads for the clasp. This will be working as the clasp. It will go hand in hand with loops that are made at the end, right when you're done with the neck piece and it's big enough to go around your neck. If you've never made a web necklace, kindly refer to my previous video. I made a video that is beginner friendly on how to make the web necklace. If you have absolutely no idea on how to make this, please refer to that video. So now I've picked up beads for my foundation. I'm just going to go through the sequence of the beads. I picked, after the 15 black beads here, I picked one white, two black, one white, two black, one white, three black, one white, three black, one white, three black, one white, five black, one white, five black, one white, five black, one white, eight black, one white, eight black, one white, eight black, one white, eight white, and one white at the end. So if you are making a web necklace and using a main color and a contrasting color, like what I'll be doing, black will be my main color, white will be my contrasting color. If you are making that type of web necklace and not using one color, for the contrasting colored bead, these white beads here, the total has to be an odd number when you're picking beads for your foundation. If you want to make a piece that is slightly smaller or that is bigger than the size that I'm making, make sure that the total of these beads is an odd number. If you find yourself with an even number, please add more beads at the bottom so that the total of these become an odd number. It will just make life much easier when you are turning if you're going to be using the method that I use. So we can start. So I'm just going to separate the very last bead here from the rest. And then I'm going to put my needle through the one after it, like that. I pull my thread until it is tight. So the pulling of the thread in beading must be done in moderation. It mustn't be way too tight. It mustn't be too loose. It should just be done in moderation so that everything sits well. Now I'm going to pick 8 white beads, 1 white for the contrasting, so that's a total of 9 white beads and 8 black beads. I've picked my beads and now I'm going to put my needle through this bead here. Coming from the bottom, it is the third contrasting bead. So there's one right at the bottom, two and three. The third one from the bottom going up, that is where the needle goes through. Like that, you can hold your beads down so that they stay in place and then pull the thread like that. So that's the first step. Now I'm going to pick 8 black beads, 1 white, and 8 black beads again. There, I've picked my beads, and now I'm going to skip this white bead and go to the next one. That is where my needle is going to go through that white bead. I pull my thread. Make sure everything is sitting neatly. So it's just about imitating the beads that are already on the foundation. Now it is time to reduce the number of beads to 5. 5 black, 1 white, and 5 black. I've picked my beads and I'm going to add them onto the neck piece. So as I did before, I'm going to skip this one and go to the next one. Put my needle through there. Pull my thread. And now I'm going to pick 5 black, 1 white, and 3 black beads. They are my beads, and I'm going to add them on. I skip this one, I go to the next one. I pull my thread. And then I will pick more beads. So now I'm going to pick 3 black beads, 1 white, and 3 black beads. They are my beads. I skip this one, I go to the next one. Pull my thread. You don't have to use a double string when you're beading. It's just that my black thread is very thin. That's why I'm using double thread, but you don't have to do that. If you have black thread that is thick enough, just use a single thread. So now I'm going to reduce the number of beads that I'm going to pick again. 2 black, 1 white, and 2 black. They are my beads, and I'm going to put my needle through the very last white bead going up. I pull my thread gently. All right, so now I am at the top. I need to turn and work going downwards. So when I am turning, I pick a total of 5 beads, and I'm going to divide these beads into 2 black, 1 white, and 2 black. So I have my 5 beads. I push them down, and now I'm going to put my needle through the very first white bead going down. So when we were coming up, we were putting the needle through these beads on this line, the very first line. Now we're going to work with the beads that we have just added. We don't cross over to this side. We add beads, the needle goes through the contrasting bead that is just right next to the beads that we will be adding. So the very first one going down is this white bead here, this one here. That is where the needle goes through, like that. And there, right? So now it is time to pick 2 beads, 1 white, and 3 beads. As I said before, we're just imitating what is on the line that is right next to where we are adding beads. So now we need 2 black, 1 white, and 3 black. I've picked my beads, and I'm going to put my needle through this white bead. I can't use this one because it is not a free bead. I used it before when I was going up, so I need to use one that is free. This one is the one that is free. The next one, I put my needle through it and I pull. Now I need 3 black beads, 1 white, and 3 black beads. I've picked my beads. I'm going to push them down and put my needle through this white bead. I'm going to skip this one. I go to the next one. Put my needle through there. pull tight. And now I'm going to pick 5 black, 1 white, and 5 black. There are my beads. Again, I skip this one. I go to the next one. Put my needle through it. I hold my beads down so that they don't move about, creating problems for me. I pull my thread. And it's time to pick more beads. 5 black, 1 white, 8 black. There are my beads. I repeat the process. I skip this white bead, go to the next one, pull my thread. I'm almost at the bottom. Now I need 8 black beads, 1 white, and 8 black beads. There are my beads, and I'm going to put my needle through this white bead here. The very first one, when we have all these many white beads, the very first one is the contrasting bead. I pull my thread, and now I need 8 white beads and 1 other white bead, which will be working as my contrasting. So that's a total of 9 white beads. So I've picked my beads, and as I did before, when you're at the bottom, you separate the very last bead from the rest and put the needle through the one that comes after it. Pull the thread, and now you can work going up. So it is the same process that I did when I was at this point. It's just picking more beads. And you keep working up. When you're at the top, you turn, you work going down. So you're going to do that until you have 5 of these V's, these white V's at the bottom. When you have 5, it'll be time to start introducing our diamonds. So just do that, and then we will get on to the next step. All right, so I have 5 of these V's at the bottom, and I'm going to start introducing the diamonds. So I am right here at the top. Remember, I said when we are turning, we need a total of 5 beads. But in this instance, we're not going to divide them into 2 black, 1 white, and 2 black. At this point, we need 2 black beads and 3 white beads. So you pick your beads, and the needle goes through the same spot that it has been going through this first white bead right at the top. That is where the needle goes through to add on the 5 beads. Pull the thread, it's sitting neatly. And now I'm going to pick 4 white beads and 3 black beads. Now, actually, I need 3 white beads and 3 black beads. We're imitating the beads that are here. So 2 for here, 1 for contrast, and 3 here. So that's a total of 3 white beads and 3 black beads. There are my 6 beads. I'm going to skip this bead here and go to the next contrasting bead, the white one, and put my needle through there. And I'm going to pull my thread. Now we have 3 beads here. So I need 3 black beads, 1 white, and 3 white here. So that's a total of 7 beads, 3 black and 4 white. So there are my beads, and I'm going to add them onto the neck piece by putting my needle through this bead here. So I'm going to do that. there. They are my beads. Now I need 6 white beads and 5 black beads. So these beads are just going hand in hand with the beads that are here. So it's 5 for these black ones, one contrast to go with this one, and 5 black to go with this one. I skip this bead, I go to the next one, and that is where my needle goes through. So you just need to understand that you add beads, you keep adding beads, imitating what is already here. The foundation that we laid here is what we have to maintain. If you just understand that bit, then it means you can play around with your numbers. You can make a bigger piece or a smaller piece. If you just understand this bit that I'm trying to explain here, it'll be so much easier for you to do many other things. You can change colors. Yeah, all sorts of things, and you can just have fun beading. All right, so at this point, I'm going to pick 5 black beads, 5 black and 9 white beads, 1 for the contrast and 8 to go hand in hand with these ones. So they are my beads. I skip this bead, I go to the next one, put my needle through this one. Next, I'm going to pick 9 white beads and 8 black beads. So they are my beads. I'm almost at the bottom. I'm going to put my needle through the very first white bead going down. That is the second from last contrasting colored bead. And now I need 9 white beads. I've picked my beads and I'm going to separate the very last one from the rest. Put my needle through the one that comes after it, pull my thread. There, it's nice and tight. So now I'm going to work going up. I'm going to start off by picking 9 white beads and 8 black beads. I've picked my beads and I'm going to put my needle through this white bead here, the first one on this white batch. Put my needle through there and I pull my thread. There. So now it is time to close off the very first diamond, and I'm going to do that by picking 17 white beads. They are my 17 white beads, and I'm going to put my needle through the very last bead going up, that white bead. I pull my thread. And there is the first diamond. And now I'm going to pick 5 black beads, 1 white and 5 black beads. I've picked my beads there. I push them down and I'm going to put my needle through this white bead, the very first one going up. That is where I'm going to put my needle through. I pull my thread, make sure it's tight and that everything is sitting neatly like that. So now I need 5 white beads, 1 for the contrasting, the one that separates our beads, and 5. So that's a total of, do I need 5? I need 3 actually. I need 3, so that's 5, 6, 9. So I need a total of 9 white beads. I've picked my beads and I'm going to put my needle through this very last bead on this batch going up. There, and there is my second diamond complete. Now I need 3 black, 1 white, and 3 black. Okay, there are my beads. I'm going to put my needle through this white bead here, which is the first one on this batch of white beads here. So that's where my needle goes through. Pull my thread. And my beads are sitting neatly. So now I just have to finish off this last diamond. And for that, I need a total of 5 white beads. There are my 5 white beads. And I'm going to put my needle through the very last white bead, the one that is right there at the top. I pull my thread. I'm just going to stop and look at my work. So there I have 3 diamonds, 1, 2, 3 diamonds. And now it is time to go back to the colors that I was working with all this time. So it's back to 5 beads at the top here, divided into 2 black, 1 white, and 2 black. I am turning and I'm going to be working going downwards. So there are my five beads. I'm going to leave the first 2 beads, the first 2 white beads right at the top there, and put my needle through the third one. Pull my thread. There. And now I need 2 black beads, 1 white, and 3 black beads. There are my beads. I push them down. And I'm going to put my needle through this white bead here. Pull my thread. I'm just going to pull right at the top and then pull at the bottom so that everything sits neatly. And now I need 3 black beads, 1 white, and 3 black beads again. There are my beads. I've picked my beads and now I'm going to count 1, 2, 3 on the fourth bead. That is where I'm going to put my needle through. My needle is going to go through the fourth white bead. I pull my thread. And then I'm going to pick more beads. This time I'm going to pick 5 black beads, 1 white, and 5 black beads. They are my beads. Going to put my needle through this white bead right there. Pull my thread. Now I'm going to pick 5 black beads, 1 white, and 8 black beads. I've picked my beads and now I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 on the 9th white bead. That is where the needle goes through. Like that. Now I'm going to pick 8 black beads, 1 white, and 8 black beads. There are my beads. I'm going to add them on by putting my needle through the very first white bead. There, when we're almost there at the bottom, I pull my thread, and now I need 9 white beads. I've picked my 9 white beads. I'm going to separate the very last one, put my needle through the one after it, pull my thread. There. All right. So now it is time to work going up. And you just maintain the main colors, or the colors that we started off with. They are the colors that you go back to when you have completed the diamonds. And then our diamonds will be separated by 5 of these V's. So when you have made 5 more in this direction and you are right at the top there, you start introducing the diamonds going down, and then you complete the diamonds when you are working going up. So that is how it goes. You just keep going up, down until your neck piece is big enough to go around your neck. So that is how it goes. It's very simple. So have fun beading, play around with colors, experiment, and see how it goes. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you found it easy to understand. For more videos, please subscribe. I'll see you next time. Bye.